It's me. We're live. So I know I said we would do a hot Pilates class today, but I am changing my mind. I remembered that many moons ago I had planned to do an advanced or kind of like intermediate asana class. And hold on, this wind is gonna sorry guys, this wind is taking over my camera. Okay. So we are gonna do the intermediate class today. It's super fun trying to figure out cameras because I'm really technical today. My flip-flop is actually holding my camera. Oh, I love it. So, don't be terrified when I say advanced. As always, I will walk you guys through options, some poses that we're gonna do. Today we're gonna do wheel, shoulder stand, bird of paradise. We're gonna work on that bind and side angle. A little fawn triangle, what else did I have planned? Oh, wild thing, yeah. So it was a class I had planned, like I said, many moons ago. And with everything going on, I just haven't had time to do it. So I figured, why not do it today? The sun is shining, I can be outside. This was kind of a pop-up surprise class anyway. So we will get started. And we are gonna get started lying down. Now I worry that my camera's too far away. Okay, I'm gonna scooch myself just a little bit closer. Sorry guys. The joy of trying to figure this out. Yay! Oh, where am I? There I am, there's my towel. Okay. Way back up. Right leg goes out nice and long. Bring that left foot in. Turn towards the right leg. Find that hold. Come all the way back up. Twist over the left. Come back. Center, find that butterfly again. Lean slightly forward. Come back up. This time the left leg goes out, right foot in. Turn towards that left leg. Come on down. Over the right side.
Inhale. And exhale. Come back to center. We're going to bring the right arm underneath the left and either hug or maybe you twist up the arms. Try to keep the elbows at shoulder height. Move through your flow, downward facing dog. Always the option to skip or take any variations of the flow. Looking up at the top of the mat, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale. Plant the hands, move through that flow, down dog. Right foot steps forward, warrior one, arms come up, hands come behind, and interlace the fingers, lift the chest and gear. Exhale, hinge forward. Hands come down, down dog. Left foot steps forward, warrior one. Hands come behind, interlace. Hinge forward. Hands come down, move through that flow, downward facing dog. Take a nice deep inhale. Full complete exhale. Left foot steps forward, warrior two. Finding that alignment, arms come up. Inhale, lifts. Exhale, lowers. Inhale. And exhale. One more inhale. And then exhale. Flip the front palm, reverse. Exhale, side angle. Now from here, this is where we're going to take our bind. So drop your left arm down, Right arm is gonna reach behind. I'm gonna turn. Reach that right, left arm up around the thigh. Grab for the fingertips. If you can't grab here, you can use a belt, you can use a strap. I'm gonna turn so I can face you guys now. Now, from here, we're gonna take a bird of paradise. So walk your back foot in and slowly, using that core, start to stand up. Woohoo! Holding here for two and one. Bring it back down. Step that foot back. Release into that side angle. Reverse it. Come back to your side angle. We're gonna go right into half moon. Hand comes down in front of your foot. I like to start with my hand on the hip. And we're gonna, open up, half moon. Hips are nice and stacked. Pushing through that back heel. Step back, warrior two. Cartwheel the hands, move through that flow. Right foot steps forward, warrior two. Exact same flow, other side. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. One more. Wheel the hands, move through that flow. Again, always the option to skip here. Come down to the knees. Find a child pose before we go into our core. So just take a nice deep inhale. Full complete breath. With each exhale, let go of any expectations, any judgments, any frustrations that you might be having. And with each inhale patience, understanding, courage, determination. Meet me in down dog. Right leg goes nice and high. From here, we're gonna find our wild thing. So I like to come forward to a plank, tip over, lift the hips, find your wild thing here. Woo. three-legged dog. Exhale, knee to right elbow. Inhale, back up. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale. Exhale, knee all the way over. Lower back foot. Drop the back heel. Fall in triangle. So fall in triangle. Think about our triangle pose feet. We're tipping it over. Hand comes down. Back to that three-legged dog. Step it through. Low lunge. Ooh, hands come up. It's a hot one, guys. Exhale, hands come down. And I love it. Unintentional hot yoga. Find that half split, nice little calf stretch. And come back to that low lunge. Bring those arms up. Hands come down. You know what's next. That flow. Love to hate. Other side. Left leg goes high. Come forward. Find that wild thing. Lift the hips. Open the chest. Bring it over here. And bring it all back. Three-legged dog. Left knee to left elbow. Inhale. Knee to nose. Knee all the way over to the right. Bring that foot down. Fall in triangle. Lift through the hips. You are stronger than you know. You can do this. Hand comes down. Three-legged dog. Step it through. Low lunge. Hands come down. Half split. Nice little hamstring stretch. Bring it forward. Last flow of the class. Bring it on down. Come down to the knees. And we're going to take a little recline butterfly like we did at the beginning of class. And close the eyes. Palms on it. Into bridge pose, and we're going to work our way into wheel, but we're going to warm up with bridge. So feet come nice and flat, bring the knees in, reach the fingertips towards the heels, lift, really use the glute here, use the core, and lower down. Exhale, lower it down. One more. Inhale. Exhale, lower. So from here, we're going to move into wheel. Option to just take bridge pose if this one makes you nervous. I know sometimes with wheel, with neck, and being with the top of the head, it can make people kind of nervous to try it for the first time. However, again, what I always like to tell people with more challenging poses, I don't like the word advanced or intermittent, but with more challenging poses, you really do not know what you are capable of until you try. And remember, with these virtual classes, if you're by yourself, nobody can see you. This is the absolute perfect time to challenge yourself, to try something new, because nobody can see you. And that's, to be honest, how I learned, we'll digress for a minute, how I learned a lot of the harder poses, like wheel, shoulder stand, eagle, kind of any of those more challenging poses, I learned a lot by practicing at home. So when I would go to classes and the teacher would work people through them, I would kind of avoid them. And then I would work on them privately at home. And then when I felt confident at my next live class, you better believe I was out there showing off. Because why not? So, again, I dare you, I challenge you to try. And just so you know, even if I know we're not doing private classes in person, but if this is something you would like help on, I can definitely do that virtually and help you with the private session. So, no more lollygagging. Wheel pose. Alrighty, let's see if I can do this in the grass. Wheel. Same setup as bridge. Feet come nice and flat. Bring the knees in. This takes a lot of glutes and a lot of tricep strength. We're gonna bring the hands close to the shoulders. So the fingertips are going to be pointing towards the body. And then from here, you're gonna use your arms to push you to the top of the head, pause there, and then bring yourself up. So I'm explaining it now because it's really hard to talk and do this pose at the same time. So push up to the top of your head, which you'll see me do, and then really use that breath. Exhale to push up. So the breath is really gonna aid you here in this pose. So we'll do this in 3, 2, and 1. And lift. Keep the knees close together. Gaze is going to be at the ground. Push through the hands. Push through the heels. Keep breathing. Coming down is the same as up. Knees stay together. Elbows in. Slowly to the head. Lower down. Butterfly. Nice job, guys. Feel free to, if you're watching this at a later time, feel free to pause here and try it again. Now we're going to move into our shoulder stand with a plow pose. Again, totally optional. If you would like to take legs up the wall for the inversion instead, feel free to do so, or again, challenge yourself. So I'm going to explain as much as I can, because again, this is kind of a hard pose to do and talk at the same time. So for our shoulder stand, what we want to do is be on that upper back, on the shoulder. So your chin's going to be tucked in. Fingers are going to be pointing up. Shoulder blades, elbows are going to be pulling in towards each other. And once we get up, we start walking the hands down, and then our goal is to be nice and straight. So you'll know as you start tipping your feet forward when you're going to be straight. And again, give me a little grace, guys. I'm outside, so I'm a little uneven, so we'll see. So from here, this is again kind of a quick pose to get in and out, but that I feel like that makes it easy. Bring the knees up. Hands come to the back. Start to lift, walk the hands down. Keep the shoulders in as close as you can. Lift up, straighten the legs. Hold here. Option to stay here, or start to walk the feet back. Nice and slow, use that core, coming into plow. Don't move your hands from your back. Slowly lift them back up. Bending that shoulder stand. Bend the knees. Roll down one at a time. Find that recline butterfly. Yay! Nice job, guys! I'm just going to assume everybody did it. And you all looked beautiful. And you all looked amazing. Because you're all badass rock stars. Now from here, left leg long, right knee in, find that supine twist. A well-earned stretch. Come back to center, supine pigeon. Woo, I'm tipping over. Baby, release. long left in. Supine twist. Supine pigeon. Close the eyes here. You have more than earned this savasana. And we're going to take a really nice long one too, guys. So settle in. Close the eyes. And we're going to take one of my favorite meditations, our color meditation. So think of your least favorite color and make it as bright in your mind as you can. With each exhale, we're going to dim that light by letting go of anything that has been pissing you off, stressing you out, anything negative. We're just going to take some weight off your shoulders, start to relax, end the week, and so you have a fresh start to the weekend. If it's something that you're not quite ready to let go of, that's perfectly okay. Just set it aside and move on to the next. Next, I want you to think of your favorite color, but this time we're going to make it really dim. And with each inhale, we're going to brighten that light by thinking of everything that makes you happy, that brings you joy, that makes you smile. And we're going to create a little gratitude list. So anytime things start to get kind of ishy or negative or sticky or stressful, you can come back to your favorite color. You can come back to this little gratitude list and smile. Simply relax and be, sit with this feeling of gratitude, sit with your favorite color, or maybe you still got some stuff to let go of. So maybe you go back to your least favorite color and continue to shed some of that weight, release some of that stress. take your time. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you tried it. I hope you had fun. I usually keep my classes very beginner friendly, all levels, but today I thought I would, you know, try something a little different. I know a lot of people like to advance their practice and try some different things. So let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you tried it. Maybe show me some pictures. I love it. I miss being in class with you guys. Thank you for your support during this time, and I hope you have an absolutely beautiful weekend. Bye, guys.